Hey guys, Virtus Education here with episode 6 of the Unreal Engine 4 Beginner Tutorial Series, and in today's episode we're going to be creating our very own geometry inside of Unreal Engine to form the foundation of our level. So far we've been going over the user interface, we've been showing you how to manipulate objects in 3D space, and now it's finally time to create our own objects to help us build whatever we want, ranging from houses to fences, walls, you know, whatever you want to make. So how are we going to be doing this? We're going to be using geometry, and we're going to be using very primitive types of geometry, and those are just going to be basic shapes, and we're going to be defining the settings for some of those, including width, height, and so on. And some of the shapes we're going to be using include the box, the cone, the cylinder, some stairs, and so on and so forth. So, let's just go ahead and create a new level of our own. I'm just going to go ahead and use the default level, and from here, we're just going to be diving straight in. So, first and foremost, you can see we've got some basic geometry here. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly delete that, as we will be starting from fresh with absolutely nothing. So, when it comes to creating geometry, it's actually really simple inside of Unreal Engine 4. Even simpler than Unreal Development Kit, in the sense that if we want an object, we just go ahead and go over to the Placement tab over here by pressing Shift and 1, go to Geometry, and then select whatever you want and just drag it into your scene. So, for example, if I wanted a sphere, I could just go ahead and drag that in, just like that, and the sphere will be made. It doesn't look very spherical at the moment, however we can play around with the properties really easily from the details panel over here. And I could do that just by changing the tessellation up to something like 5, and you can see that, you know, it looks a bit more like a sphere now. And I can do the same for pretty much anything that I want. For example, I could go ahead and do this for a cylinder. Not stairs, sorry, I don't want those. Cylinder. And that will come in there. I can play around with the properties here. For example, sides, I could change that to something like 15. And you'll see it becomes a little bit more smoothed. You know, I can then proceed to change around the height being the z-axis. So, for example, I could set this to 25. It'd be small, flat, round, and very smooth. You know, I can do a whole bunch of different stuff using this. So let's just go ahead and bring in a box. And we wanted to go ahead and play around with some of the properties. So I'm just going to quickly scrap this level, it isn't saved, and we're going to start building a house. So you can actually see pretty much how we can go ahead and bring in these basic shapes that we have here. So first and foremost, we're going to need some floor, so I'm going to be using a box. And I don't necessarily want the floor to be that thick, so what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to go ahead and change the z-axis, and I'm going to set this to about 25 to make it nice and flat. And you can see we've got our floor here pretty much exactly like, well, you know, a floor. Now, if we wanted walls, for example, we could go ahead and do exactly the same. All we've got to do is just go ahead and Control-C, Control-V, and copy that. Let's just go ahead and do that. Copy. And then paste, and then we can just go ahead and rotate it to make the walls. So let's just go ahead and move this up. Now we've used Control-C, Control-V. Alternatively, you could just go ahead and drag Alt, and it'll make a duplicate copy. Let me show you just like that, and then we have two objects out of one. So let's just go ahead and rotate this wall now. Boom, just like that. Now, as you can see, when it comes to rotating walls and stuff, the snapping for rotation is definitely going to be needed, so I'm just going to make sure that I have that on so I can easily get exactly 90 degrees that I wanted, because we don't want, you know, wonky walls. So let's just go ahead and move it all the way over to the side, and once again, you can see that snapping will be really great here. We want to be able to get it perfectly aligned, and if you can't, you can just turn it on and off to get it exactly how you want. Now, as of right now, I feel this is a little bit too tall, so let's just go ahead and play around with the, which axis is this? I'd say this would be the y-axis, because, you know, the y-axis. Just go ahead and play around with this. Now, that's kind of why it gets a little bit confusing when you start rotating the object, because you don't know which axis is which. I just had, an educated guess there, and I got it right. So, rather than actually going ahead and, you know, rotating your object, just play around with the different axes on here. It makes it a hell of a lot simpler. So, Having said that, I'm just going to leave it there. And then what I'm going to do now is I'm going to set the z-axis to something nice and tall, say 100. And then I'm going to just increase it a little bit more, because we want it to be a little bit taller than that, say 500. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to change the y-axis, which is the green one here. I'm going to set this to 25. And then the x-axis is perfectly fine, just where it is. So now we've got our walls, let's just go ahead and drag that down just like that into place. And once again, I can just copy and paste this if I wanted to. So let's just go ahead and hold down Alt, and then drag it over, and it will make a duplicate just like that. Very, very simple. Now, if you have to drag an object a little bit further than the camera does, just hold down Alt, Shift, and then it will drag the object and the camera with it, which is pretty cool. But for now, I'm just going to go ahead and place this in the very center of the building here. So, this is pretty much how we would go ahead and form the foundation of a level or whatever, just using this basic geometry, which I'll be showing you how to modify in a little bit more detail in a later video. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to copy one last bit here, using Alt to drag it up to form the ceiling of this little room of mine. So you can see it's pretty simple making basic buildings and whatnot. So there is an easier way to do this with blocks, that being that if I just go ahead and get my box, drag it straight in here, and then just go ahead and check hollow. And what this will do is make the inside of this box nice and hollow now. So let's just go ahead and turn that on and off. From the inside, there's nothing right now, and you can't actually get in there. Turn it on, you can see there's empty space inside of there. If I wanted to, I could even go ahead and run inside of here. Let me just go ahead and add a light in here real quick. Add place actor, point light, and you can see that, you know, we do actually have space inside of there. And all we need to do is just go ahead and cut the shape out of the wall. So let's just go ahead and show you how I can do that. And I'm going to be doing this to create a quick doorway into my little room that I have here. So if I wanted to do that, just go ahead and press select, subtract, drag in that box, and then as you can see, as I move it, it's actually subtracting whatever is in that area. So let's just go ahead and shape this to make it a little bit more like some a door, for example. So as you can see here, the x-axis is way too wide, so I'm going to set this to something like 15. Too small, I can change it up to 100. And that's looking a little bit more like a door now. Let's just go ahead and drag that down into place just like that, and we have our door. It's as simple as that. So let's just go ahead and run around in here and, you know, just see what we can do. So it's very dark in here at the moment, we can't see anything, but if I was to go ahead and build my lighting quickly, you can see that it's going to be nice and bright, we can run around it, and we can actually enjoy, you know, the fruits of our labor, our very first building inside of here. So over the duration of this series, we're actually going to be creating you know, a house and some gardens and some other props and whatnot, just to show you what all of the tools can do, and just to have somewhere that we can use all of them in conjunction for testing purposes. So I'm going to go ahead and end off the video here. Feel free to play around with geometry, you know, the different shapes, the different properties for all of them, ranging from size, hollow, tessellation, and so on, and make sure you do that for both additive geometry, you know, to place stuff in the scene, and subtractive geometry to take things out. For example, this door, you know, you might want to play around with making windows or, you know, skylights and whatnot. Anyway, so thanks for watching, comment, like, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next episode. Goodbye.